Lossless Scaling, a very popular app among gamers on Windows, enables frame generation and upscaling on all games. On Linux, this was not possible yet. There's GameScope that can help upscale games that don't support it natively, but nothing that enables Framegen in games without that option. Enter LSFG-VK, short for Lossless Scaling Frame Generation, on Vulkan. Does it work well? Let's find out after the intro. I figured I'd give it a try on two different systems. My fiery red PC that has an RX 5700 XT as shown in this video, and the Ubox that I reviewed in this one. Let's start with the Ubox since that's the least performant of the two. This machine has a Ryzen 5 6600H APU with Radeon 660M graphics and 16GB of DDR5 memory. I'm running OpenMandriva on this machine, let's see if it will install on that. There's an install script on their GitHub page. Let's just try that. Fedora is closest, I guess. Oh wow, already? I did not speed this up. Let's just try. We need to set LSFG as 1 to enable the software, and LSFG multiplier to tell us how much fake frames we want to generate. Yes, I don't have the original Lossless Scaling tool installed yet. You do need that for this to work. Let's go into Steam and install that. You do need to buy this, by the way, it's not free software. Alright, done. We can now exit Steam, so it won't take up any resources for games outside of it. Let's try again. Alright, well, at least it seems to work. Let's try Sir Whoopass Immortal Death. Without it, I got some 25-ish FPS. Let's set our new favorite set of environment variables. Little better. Let's raise the multiplier to 4, just for fun. Mango Hut does show a higher number, but this is totally unplayable. There's some more options, most notably LSFG Flow Scale and LSFG Perf Mode. I would love to see a description on what both options exactly mean, but in my testing I haven't seen great results by lowering the flow scale. But what if we add the performance mode variable and set the multiplier back at 2? That does seem to help quite a bit. Nice! Doom Eternal does about 45 FPS without frame gen. Let's add LSFG to the game's Steam launch options. Oof, less than 20 FPS? That's not good. Maybe performance mode helps here as well. An almost constant 30 FPS? I guess this one works better without it. Oh Baby Cart doesn't perform well on this machine at 1080p and the settings shown on screen. It's given me somewhere between 15 and 35-ish FPS. Let's add Framegen. Well, you could argue that it makes the frame rate more stable, but I was hoping to see more of that higher number. With performance mode added, it's a little better, but it felt more playable without frame gen. So results are all over the place, with only Sir Whoopass giving us a positive result on this machine. I guess it's a game of trial and error anyway. Let's move over to the PC under my desk. It has an Intel i5 8500 CPU, an AMD RX 5700 XT GPU, and 16GB of DDR4 memory. It's running Arch Linux and installing was very simple, as LSFG-VK is in AOR, so it could just use the YAI package manager. RAID 4, VSync enabled and kept at 120 FPS, because the LSFG-VK wiki tells me that it's a good idea to do so, reaches that number often at 1440p without frame gen. I've seen over 150 without the cap, by the way, but I forgot to film the proof of that. Let's see if adding Framegen can help me match my 240Hz monitor. It's staying right under 100fps this time. Still a nice frame rate, but it was better without it. Let's add performance mode. Way over 200fps! Cool! I did try to lower the flow scale to 0.5 as well, which in this game seems to help quite a bit, giving me a very nice 160-ish fps. But performance mode helps quite a bit more, as you have just seen. I tested Doom the Dark Ages on this machine before in this video, which provided me a decently playable 40-45-ish fps at 1080p low settings in places with lots of demons around me. This was an interesting test, as this RX 5700 XT does not support ray tracing, and Doom the Dark Ages actually requires it to run, so it's emulated on the card. This game has native Framegen support, but when I enable it on both this machine and the Minus4M PC I tested recently, I just got a black screen. What if we use Lossless Scaling's Framegen instead? With a multiplier at 2 and performance mode enabled, I'm getting a nice 70-ish fps. Could I turn it back up to 1440p? 70fps as well! It does drop quite a bit when it's busy around me, but it's very playable. This is a great option for playing this game on an older graphics card like this one. It doesn't seem to help to get better performance on Half-Life 2 RTX on this card. That title is just too demanding for this one. How about Doom Eternal on this machine? This one has no issues getting decent frame rates without it, wobbling a bit between 90-ish and way over 150fps at 1440p high settings. With LSFG-VK added, I'm seeing frame rates way over 200fps. Cool! Do my 44-year-old eyes actually see the difference? Nah, but that's not the point! In Shadow of the Tomb Raider, ray tracing disabled at 4040p and high preset, the frame rate way over 130fps drops to just over 70fps at this place. With Framegen added, the frame rate doubles. Nice! Pretty cool results on this machine, I'd say. LSFG-VK only supports Vulkan, so what if we run an OpenGL game through Zinc? Native OpenGL, Super Tux card at 1440p and the highest possible settings gives me just over 100fps most of the time. When I run it through Zinc, which translates OpenGL to Vulkan, that drops to an 80-ish fps mostly. Now let's add Framegen. Around 220fps! I'd say this works pretty well, given your hardware can already provide a semi-playable frame rate in the games you wish to run. Shout out to Dot3 Productions on Discord for sending me a link to LSFG-VK. That's all I have for you today. Just when I was editing this video, I noticed a new version in which the environment variables config has been changed in favor for a config file. So we should be able to remove this. Then we need to look up the executable name, for example by checking the installed files, I guess. write4.exe, check. That doesn't seem to work. Maybe I really need to add the .exe extension? No? The wiki states you can still use environment variables, but you'll have to use lsfg_legacy_1 instead of enable lsfg. Let's try that. I guess it works, but now it's capped at 60fps because I'm using my capture device that doesn't accept a higher refresh rate. So let's film the screen again with my camera. kinda looks like the result I got without performance mode. Oh, I'm running at 1080p. Have I been spreading misinformation about that in the first test I showed you? Let's put it at 1440p and windowed mode, as LSFG-VK seems to prefer that.
I think so. I think I might have run it at 1080p all along. Oops. Because I'm not getting the 150-ish FPS I got the last time. Ah, shit. Okay. Oh, options. Can we change options from here? Oh, we can. Like a 1080. Ah, yeah. Window mode disabled. Yeah. I think we were running 1080 all along.
So let's check the executable in the process list.
Write4.exe. Why is it not picking it up? What am I doing wrong? Pin. Oh. Maybe this is the executable. Write4win64shipping.exe. Let's try that. Little bigger for you guys to see. Ah. Should I do that .exe or not? I don't know. I really don't know. No, it's not working. Maybe without .exe. Nope, not working at all.
Maybe put it under global?
Nope. It's again kept at 120, so no, it's not doing anything.
Maybe I should change game to the name of the game? Just trying things here.
I mean, I'm bad at this game either way, but... Yeah, with dynamic FPS it's better, but here's your proof, it reaches 150 FPS. But fuck me. Why is it not working anymore? Straight to 120. Windowed or not, doesn't matter.
We can set lsfg underscore process as a variable to match the config. Maybe that helps. Yes! Over 200 FPS again. Well, this is really all I have for you today. I sure hope you enjoyed watching me struggle with this. Thank you very much for watching all the way to the end. Until next time.